We do know that mutations could lead to the emergence and spread of even more concerning variants of the virus that could spread worldwide within a few months. It is now important that all of us in Europe act very swiftly, decisively, and united. The European Commission has today proposed to Member States to activate the emergency brake on travel from countries in Southern Africa and other countries affected to limit the spread of the new variant. All air travel to these countries should be suspended. They should be suspended until we have a clear understanding about the danger posed by this new variant. And travelers returning from this region should respect strict quarantine rules. I've spoken about the situation today with scientists and vaccine manufacturers. They, too, fully support such precautionary measures to avoid international spreading of the concerning variant. It also depends on all of us as citizens to contribute to a better control of the pandemic.
Over the next few weeks, we were already planning to do 6 million booster jabs in England alone. But against this backdrop of this new variant, we want to go further and faster. So I asked the JCVI, the government's independent expert advisers on vaccinations, to urgently review how we could expand the programme and whether we should reduce the gap between second doses and boosters. The JCVI published its advice in the last hour. First, it advised that the minimum dose interval for booster jabs should be halved from 6 months to 3 months. Second, that the booster programme should be expanded to include all remaining adults aged 18 and above. Third, that these boosters should be offered by age group in a descending order to protect those who are most vulnerable to the virus. So priority will be given to older adults and people over 16 who are at risk. Fourth, that severely immunosuppressed people aged 16 or above who've received 3 primary doses should now also be offered a booster dose. Finally, that children aged between 12 and 15 should be given a second dose 12 weeks from the first dose. I have accepted this advice in full.
I've seen in the news overnight 3 confirmed cases. I'll be honest with you and your viewers, I would expect that to rise. We don't know by what speed or by what numbers, so therefore what we're doing is trying to slow it down, but we're clear we can't stop it. But it's still early days in terms of understanding how it actually reacts in terms of transmissibility, in terms of how dangerous it is. Therefore, let's let the scientists do their work, but we've taken some proportionate, measured steps to help slow down the spread and the seeding of that variant while they do their work. Hopefully, it won't be a huge concern. We don't know how it'll react in terms of older people or with the vaccine. So hopefully, that is what we will see, not just in South Africa, but around the world. Sajid Javid, as you will know, has asked the JCVI, the Joint Committee on Vaccinations and Immunisations, for advice urgently on bringing down the gap potentially between second and booster jabs, but also in terms of whether the booster programme should be extended downwards in terms of age range.